Schizophrenia was created a little less than a century ago. It was done by a single man. His name was Eugen Bleuler. Now Bleuler was a doctor in Switzerland, a psychiatrist by trade. He learned in med school that young people who heard voices in their head were doomed. This was the opinion of Emil Kraepelin, the German father of psychiatry. Kraepelin called this dementia praecox. Sigmund Freud used the same term. So did Carl Jung, before he adopted Bleuler's label. Schizophrenia was created a little less than a century ago. Yes, schizophrenia was created by doctors a little less than a century ago. Now schizophrenia translates from the Latin a split mind. The label and that of schizophrenics is unjust and unkind. Hollywood creates stereotypes of murderous madmen. The magazines tell us of new drugs for clinical correction of genetic imbalances. The old lies of the Nazis and eugenics revived, and they try to convince a skeptical public that the shrinks have the answers. With diplomas and doctorates in which drug to prescribe, with lawyers to convince about those who can be confined for involuntary treatment that poisons the brain, custodial treatment that tortures the mind. For involuntary treatment that poisons the brain, custodial treatment that tortures the mind. The textbooks, if they mention the history at all, paint psychiatric treatment as a steady improvement led by the church and professional reformers. The chains and whips were abolished and new treatments accorded by those now called consumers and clients rather than prisoners. But the drugs made them shuffle and shake. The drugs made them tired and keep them awake. The drugs make them pace and they seem mad. The drugs make them feel neither happy nor sad. The drugs made them numb and glazed like a zombie. And this day's condition they name schizophrenia. Spoken of us and less written about is the marketing of drugs that block dopamine receptors. They are described as antipsychotics or neuroleptics. They used to be called major tranquilizers, but these drugs don't make you tranquil and they don't make you sane. They do make you shake and they damage the brain. injected into people against their wills. They are also prescribed as involuntary pills. This is in the guise of medical treatment. These drugs are standard treatment for schizophrenia. Now, I have been injected with these drugs myself, so I can describe how they felt. Every word had to be forced out, and my hand moved like a spider. I felt restless and paced around, an effect called akathisia. And akathisia is caused only by these drugs, but even worse is tardive dyskinesia. The disease is permanent, even if the drugs are stopped. Arms and legs wreathe around, the movements involuntary, the cheeks puff and the tongue sticks out, the stigma is extraordinary. Yeah, the stigma is extraordinary.